Hi, welcome to the 3D solid modeling session. So in this session I will teach you that how we can design a 3D plastic bottle. And first of all I will create a 2D geometry. So we will go to the wireframe tab and first we will create a rectangle. Suppose we need overall length, width we need suppose 80 mm, and height we will use 120 mm, no we will keep it 150 mm, and then okay. So this it will be the overall dimensions of that bottle, width and height. So first of all we will create a radius shape on the top. So we will offset it from here, offset from this point to this point. We will keep it 50 mm, no we will keep it 35 mm, and after that we will create a radius. So we will go to the arc command and we will use arc end points. So suppose we have to create a radius from this point, so we need to offset it also. We will offset it from here to here. So what will be the dimension? We will keep it 25 mm, and then we will create that arc end points from this point to this point, and we will use the radius of 50. Okay, it's looking good. And we will trim that area, divide and trim all that area. Okay, and after that we will create a center line by using line commands. So what will be the length? We will keep it 165. Okay, and here we will create cap shape. So we will keep it a simple square type of cap, and we will give radius on the top. We will go to the fillet entities and we will give the radius of 2 mm, and here also we can give the radius 2 mm, so it will be smooth. We will divide it, we will delete that. Okay, and after that we will create some radius type of shape here. So what we will do, we will create a center point, circle center point on this edge, and we will keep it 5 mm of radius. And now we will translate it, translate from this point to this point. The length should be 15 mm in minus. Okay, delete this one, and we will change the radius value wireframe, and here we will take arc endpoints from this point to this point. Sorry, from this point to this point, and we will give the radius of 5 mm. No, not 5 mm, we will give it 2.5. no, let's try 20 mm. No, 15. Okay, it's looking good. Divide this area, and this area. And we will give a corner radius on this edge, so it will remove the sharp edges here and here. Okay, so we will translate this radius portion once more here, translate, and then copy minus 15 mm. Okay, is it looking good? Okay, divide it, and after that we will create radius on this point also, fillet entities, we will give it 5 mm of radius here, and then okay. Okay, so now we will create a radius type of shape on the bottom area. So here we'll go to the arc endpoint tab, and we will keep at here to here, but before that we need to offset it, so we can define the value also. So we will offset it maximum 5 mm. Okay, it's looking good. So we will create the arc endpoints again, arc endpoints from this point to this point, so it will be very higher. So we will keep it lower from this point to this point. So first we need to offset a entity from here to here, so we can define the points also. So we will offset it from here to here. So offset it. So we will offset it 10 mm. No, we will keep it 20 mm. Okay, it's looking good. So now we will create that arc endpoints from this point to this point, and we will give the radius. We will keep it 25 mm. Is it looking higher? No, we will change it. We will keep it 30. Okay, it's looking good. And we will divide it. Okay, and after that we will give some radius value here, so it will be smoother. 25. Now it will be very higher, so we will change it 15. Let's give only 5 mm for smoothness. And we will remove this area also. And so we have done the wireframe designing. So now what we have to do, we will go to the solid tab and we will use here revolve command. Select the revolve command and select the chain. This is the chain. So it is showing some error here. So there is some gap area. So we will trim it. Trim two entities from here to here. Okay. Solid revolve from this entity. And now it is asking select a line to be used as the axis of rotation. So we will use this line as the axis of rotation. Okay, it's looking good. And after that we will change the color. Okay, it's looking good. So now what we will do, we will create some design on this face and on this face also. So I will first we will decide that which type of shape we have to wrap on this face. So first we will create a simple rectangle of 40 by 20. So it will be higher than this length, so we will change it. We will keep it 30. Yeah, okay, it's looking good. And now we will define the shape. Suppose we have to define this kind of shape. And we will go to the arctangent. We will use our three entities. This line, this line, and this line. And I think we should change it. I think this shape will be better than that one. Okay, we will divide it here, 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 and here, and we will give radius, some radius value here, and here also only 1 mm. Okay, so now what we will do, we will extrude it, solid, and then extrude this area at here, okay, and we will translate it. Select all the wireframe and bodies and go to the transform tab, use translate and use the x-axis and use the center point here, and I will active the wireframe mode, and here you can say move it. Okay, so now what we will do, okay, so we need maximum 1 mm of depth from this face, so we will select this curve and then we will offset it wireframe, and then offset from this point to this point. I will keep it 1 mm only. Depth value will be only on 1 mm. I will select that. I will select that solid also, not wireframe, only solid. Select the solid and then say alt plus e means hide command. So you can hide all other entities and you can keep the selected entities on the screen. So that will be very easier to work. You will not get disturbed. So what we will do, we will create the complete boundary so we can revolve it. We can cut that body from that face. So as you can see, I'm just drawing that complete boundary. I will close it from everywhere and I will say trim two entities, this line and this line and this line. Okay, and solid, go to the solid tab and then revolve it. Select all the boundaries. Okay, select the axis where you want to rotate it. As you can see, I will active the solid mode. So you can see here I will click cut body, so it will create the shape with the matching radius of that bottle shape. So it will be matched with that radius. So we can after that we will remove this tool body from that bottle, so we will get that, we will get this impression on that bottle. So let's say okay, and suppose you need some radius value here, so you can give here constant fillet. So I will give a maximum, I will select the face and I will give the radius 0.3. No, I will give 0.5. Okay, it's looking good. And now I will say alt plus e means unhide. So you can see, if you will see in right view, so you can understand that you will get the 1 mm negative impression of this solid body. So we need it maximum 3 to 4 times. So we will go to the back view. This is the back view. So we will rotate it by using circular pattern. So we'll go to the circular solid tab and we will use here circular pattern and we will select it. We will select this solid body, and then here we will say in angle option you can say 360 divided by 6, and here you have to give the number of rotation 6 times. So we will define the center point. This is the center point. So it is giving some warnings. So as you can see, there is instances value. So we will remove that. First we will remove that, and then we will try it again. Circular pattern, and I think we forgot to active the construction plane. So it would be back view. So go to the again circular pattern, select the target body and then select the tool body and then okay. So So as you can see, we really forgot that we have to active construction plan where we have to work, right? So we were working in back view, so we forgot to active the C construction plan. That's why the software was giving errors. So keep remember that you have to active the C plan in which work plane you are working, active that. So here I will give 360 divided by 6 time. So it is 6 time, okay, fantastic. All right, so 6 time, okay, and I will say solid body cut. So as you can see, if I will say solid body cut, so you will get the impression of that tool body like this. So you can see how easily we designed this shape. It's very easy to use. And now what we will say, okay, and now we will design one more shape here, but after that we will give some fillets and radius for smoothness, because this edge is looking very sharp. So it's not looking good. And we can use this geometry also. So but that geometry is very small, so we will create once more again. Here we will change the design also. So what we will do, we will create one more rectangle here, we will create that also. We can create we forgot to change the construction plane. Keep it top, select it and give the values. Suppose we need 30 width and height, we will keep 40, no 40, we will keep it 50, okay. If you want, you can change it 55, okay. So now we will create the, we will keep it rectangle type of shapes. So before that, we will create we will change it in a capsule type of shape. Arctangent, arc 3 entities, first, second and third. Sorry, arctangent, first, second and third. Okay, it's looking good. Divide it. Okay, so now we will extrude it. Simply we will extrude by using solid extrude command. Solid extrude this area and then say okay, and give the values which 50 is fine, 50 height is fine. So now what we will do, we will translate it in the center of the bottle. Translate from this face to, so this coordinate to this coordinate, and then say move, and then say okay. So we will use the same procedure as previously we have used in this design. So what we will do, we will select this curve and select this body, and then say Alt plus E. So you can hide that. Alt plus E means hide and hide command. So we will go to the again solid tab, and first we need to close it, because without close, if we will not close it, we can't revolve it. So we will create the lines from midpoints, and we will say trim two entities, and then okay, and then I think we forgot to offset it, so we will offset it also 1 mm. Okay, trim two entities, this line. Go to the solid tab and use revolve command, select this curve and then say okay, and revolve by this axis and say cut body. So very simply you can make that radius type of shape, and we will give the constant fillet here, or if you need chamfer and all, you can also give that. So I will give radius only, that will be better. Okay, so I will say home on hide, you can say Alt plus E also. And after that, what we will do, we will go to the front view and we will use the same command like circular pattern, select the target body and select the tool body and then say OK. And we can define the values, we need it only 6 times. So we forgot the construction plane to active the, we will keep it front view. And as you can see, here we have rotated that tool body 6 times on that face and then say OK. So we did this also. So now what we will do, we will give some fillets. If you need fillets, you can give here fillets also. So I will give the fillets. I will select this face by edge selection. I will click the shift key. So it will select all the edges automatically. Here also I will say shift click, double click. Here also double click, shift and double click. It is giving some errors. Okay. So once you will click a single edge, it will automatically detect the similar edges. Automatically it will detect that and it will create the fillets on that edge. Okay, it's looking good. So we will create some fillets here also. We can select it in one time, so it will not be our time wasting. Okay, in one time you can select all the edges. So in one time you will get all the fillets. Okay. And I will say okay, and I will change the metal view. I will keep it in plastic level and I will change the model color also. Sorry, I will keep it I will keep this color. So now it's looking good, fantastic. And if you have to create a cavity of this bottle, so simply you can create that wireframe, go through the wireframe tab, rectangle, and create the, we will active the C plane, top view, we will create the rectangle at this point, and then say OK, and I will extrude it, solid extrude from this edge. And then say this side. Okay. And what we will do, we will remove it. Let's do it. Solid boolean command, select the target body and select the tool body and then say okay, and we will say remove. So you can see how easily we have created the mold, but we need that actual part, right? We need that bottle model. So here you can click non-associative, keep the original tool solid. So we need the tool solid, right? We don't want to lose it. Okay. So this is the actual mold. We will change the color. I will make it in metal level. And simply you can remove this area also. So I will show you that how we can do that. I will go to the model for present tab and I will say push pull. I will click this face and this face. We have to select this face, and after that this face, and okay. We can through this area, because in the blow mode we have to through this area, otherwise we can't add the bush here. So you can see how easily we can create the part, and also how we can easily create the dies in MasterCam. We can create the mold, we can create the core cavities, all the things we can design in MasterCam.